So very simply, you inhale gently first. Well, not now. I'm just introducing. You inhale gently first, and then exhale sort of a little bit strong and a little bit deep, you know, three times. So it's a way to somehow unnecessary, let's say, oxygens, let's say, and that is somehow lingering in our system to ventilate that. And after that, then you breathe, try to breathe steady, always through your nose, not through your lips, and then always try to maintain your back straight, you know, with a straight back. So not slouching, or not sideways, and also not completely backwards, and also not, you know, too rigidly stretching also. Yeah. And what else? Yeah. Then also the level of one's head shouldn't be too up high, shouldn't be too low. Shouldn't be also too much on the sides. Just more or less balanced. And a little bit downwards, a little bit. And then the eyes. When we begin, it's better that we close our eyes. Later on, when we get used to calming the mind, when we are able to calm the mind at will, then we can open the eyes a little bit, but not too much. The point is where sort of like if you do it like that, you know. So it's basically, you know, along the line of the nose. So right about that tip. So not here, you know, right there. So yeah. So and also the tongue also shouldn't be going anywhere, but sort of, you know, staying in contact with the upper palate. Yeah. And also our lips should be more or less sort of, not forcefully, but naturally sealed, yes, so that we don't breathe through our lips or through our mouth. Because then we are not able to, let's say, if we breathe through our nose, then we, let's say, also filter whatever we breathe in. So it's much better for the lungs. And then what else? And then in terms of the hand posture, it doesn't really matter. You can just have it resting both the hands, the palm of your hands on your knees, or what is known as the best is, you know, sort of like a it's known as the mudra of stating the mind in a composed and undivided state. I think, yeah, like that. Yeah. So the left palm underneath, and then the right palm on and over it. And what else? Well, there are many things, but those are the basics. And what you try to do is initially, if you have too many thoughts, if you are not able to calm the mind at all, too busy. If the mind is too busy, then we have no choice but to somehow force oneself to calm it a little bit. But we shouldn't overdo it. If you overdo it, then we will not be able to meditate at all. The mind will never become calm. Then we will not enjoy. Well, we're not supposed to enjoy the meditation, but that there will be no, let's say, there will be no joy in. There will be no joy in meditation. There's no tranquility in meditation. So. if it's too busy, then force it to, let's say, somehow bring the mind back wherever it's going. And then once it's stable, then also have awareness and be mindful of also of not of the mind not turning towards, you know, the mind going down. So that's another. Then now, in terms of what you have to meditate, there is no real, let's say, guideline. There are many ways one can meditate. Often the best way to somehow bringing the mind in control and at peace and at calm, and may make it calm, is to count, in a way, to count one's breath. You inhale slowly, you exhale slowly, and every time you do that, you count as one. So like 1, 2, and that. Because the reason why we do that is because the mind is too busy, and if you just put it, if you just let it be quiet, the mind will become agitated, and because it is used to move. So we're giving some movement, but very with a good rhythm, and that rhythm is neither it's virtuous nor non-virtuous. It's just semi, just in between. That's why it's easier to. It's a good method to give the mind something to do, but nothing negative. And in that way, the mind will become much more flexible and much more calm. So probably we do that, I think. So first, we inhale and exhale 3 times to clear our lungs. So now stay focused, and one other thing is try to breathe from your abdomen rather than from your chest. In that way, it's much better. And know that in this moment, during this moment, nothing matters. Okay. So now, slowly then, we inhale one last time. Then exhale long and slow. Okay. So today is just a very basic form of meditation, but it's as I said before, it's very essential. If you have trouble meditating, whatever practice we do, then this is the sort of thing that we need to do, and then it will become easier for whatever little practices we do. Actually, this sort of meditation, if it's for 1 minute or 5 minutes, it's very advisable to do, to perform, to practice, and before anything important, you know, any important things that you have to do, let's say making a decision, and mostly making decisions. Yeah. Sometimes we get lost, not knowing what to cook today. Yeah. So even on that part, it'll help. So then I thank you very much. I had a wonderful time with all of you. May it be of great benefit for all of you, for whatever Dhamma that we have shared together. So we dedicate all this also to all sentient beings. Okay? Sonam di yantam je rebwa yantam ne nyebe danam jeganam je balam truva ye sebe sole nowa nowa esho. Thank you, and very good evening.